In our asset allocation committee, we like emerging market stocks relative to developed market stocks. But at the top level, we are neutral between U.S. and non-U.S. stocks. No one likes a two-handed economist, but I'm not an economist. So let me give you my top two reasons to favor U.S. stocks and my top two reasons to favor non-U.S. stocks. In favor of U.S. stocks, there is a clear stimulus advantage. The year-over-year increase in money growth, a proxy for stimulus measures, in the US has been more than four times the increase in Europe, Japan, the UK, and China. US authorities just had more dry powder available than the rest of the world. Second, US stocks enjoy an important sector advantage. US stocks are comprised of 27% technology companies compared to 7.5% in Europe, for example. So the US economy has been and could continue to be more dynamic, more innovative, or vibrant, if you will. And US stocks remain more resilient in a continued low interest rate environment. Now, perhaps I've convinced you to overweight US stocks, but wait, in favor of non-US stocks, we likely have a smoother recovery from the pandemic. Markets typically look not for the resolution of economic shocks, but rather for the stop getting worse moment. With regards to the number of cases and the impact of the pandemic on economic activity, it appears the US is lagging the rest of the world. The second of my top two reasons in favor of non-US stocks is a potentially weakening US dollar. The narrowing of the growth differential and interest rate differential that have favored the US and the massive supply of liquidity I mentioned could continue to push the US dollar lower. Equity investors sometimes underestimate the impact of currencies on their unhedged foreign equity exposures. This factor could play an important role in the months ahead. Notice that I haven't mentioned the valuation advantage for non-US stocks as one of my top two reasons to like the asset class. It is a factor we look at, but it has poor historical performance as a tool for tactical asset allocation at the 6 to 18 month horizon. And sector differences can weaken the signal significantly. The bottom line, when it comes to US versus non-US stocks, we believe that diversification is the name of the game. As we tell our clients, don't be a hero, stay invested, and stay diversified.